I'm Shiny. Today I'm going to explain on the topic grouping of capacitors. Grouping of capacitors are in two ways. First one is in series, second one is in parallel. First, I would like to explain capacitors are connected in series. Three capacitors. Three or two. I have drawn here three capacitors. C1, C2, C3 are connected in series. Like this it is. Series. C1, C2, C3 are connected in series. Then connected with the battery. Then potential difference. That means V1 is the voltage across the capacitor C1. Voltage across C1. Next one. Otherwise, potential difference across C2. Third one, V3 means potential difference across C3. The capacitor, we know that one side it is plus Q charge, one side is minus Q charge. Here also plus Q, here is minus Q. Here also same, plus Q and minus Q. Then we know that total voltage, this is voltage across C1, this is voltage across V2, voltage across that C3. Then total voltage, that is V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. This in case of three capacitors are connected in series. Two capacitors are connected in series means V is equal to V1 plus V2. 3 means plus V3. Then N capacitors means plus V4 plus etc. plus Vn. Then we know that we are already studied. Q is equal to CV. Okay, C into capacitance into that is potential difference. Then from this equation we can write V equal to Q by C. Then V1 is equal to Q by C1. V2 is equal to Q by C2. Then similarly, V3 is equal to Q by C3. Then we can substitute this V1, V2, V3, V also we can substitute here. From this equation 1. Then we can substitute Q by C equal to Q by C1 plus Q by C2 plus Q by C3. Then which term is common? That is Q is common. We can take outside. Then we can write Q by C is equal to Q into 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. Then Q is cancelled. Then effective capacitance or total capacitance. Total capacitance, effective capacitance is equal to 1 by C is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. This is our final equation. Three capacitors are connected in series. Our final equation means, that means reciprocal of capacitance is the combination of sum of reciprocal of each capacitance. 1 by C equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. Then N capacitors are connected in series. How to write? 1 by Cn equal to, otherwise 1 by C equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3 plus etc. plus 1 by Cn. Next is second topics in parallel. Consider three capacitors, that is C1, here is C2, next one is C3. Consider three capacitors C1, C2, C3 are connected in parallel. Second case, capacitors are connected in parallel. Then we know that here is voltage potential across this ends of the capacitor. That is same for each capacitor. Then, here, charges This side is plus Q, this side it is minus Q. Here also plus Q and minus Q. Then here is the charge. Total charge is the sum of individual charges. Total charge is the sum of individual charges. Then charge, that is Q, is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. In case of three capacitors, Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. In case of four capacitors, Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4. N capacitors plus QEN. Then we know that Q is equal to CV. Then similarly we can write Q1 is equal to C1V. Then next Q2 is equal to C2V. Q3 is equal to C3V. Thus we can substitute in our main equation. Equation number 1. Then instead of Q, what do I have to write? CV. CV is equal to, instead of Q1, what do I have to write? C1V. Plus instead of Q2, C2V. Plus instead of Q3, C3V. Which term is common? That is V is equal to, V is common, we can take outside. CV equal to V into C1 plus C2 plus C3. Then V is cancelled. Then our final equation C equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. Three capacitors are connected in series. C equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. Then in case of n capacitors, how to write? C equal to C1 plus C2 plus C2 plus C3 plus C4 plus etc. plus Cn. That means here is C. Total capacitors is the sum of individual capacitors. Total capacitance, that is effective capacitance, C. C is equal to, is the sum of which one? C1 plus C2 plus C3, individual capacitance. Thank you. Tomorrow we will discuss on the topic energy stored in a capacitor.